Lord Shiva and Sage Agastya. Lord Shiva and Parvati were getting married at the same time in the Himalayas in the north, when Kaveri was worshipping Brahma in the Sahaya mountains in the south. All people, sages and gods started flocking to the north to witness the divine union of two souls. As a result, the earth began to tilt towards the north. The earth was in danger of toppling over. Shiva was worried. He could not ask his guests to leave the wedding venue. It would be an insult to them. But at the same time, he had to find a solution quickly. So Shiva decided to ask Sage Agastya for a favor. He requested Agastya to go southward, as he was the only one who could balance the universe by his supreme powers. Agastya agreed, even though he was sad that he could not witness the divine marriage. Agastya proposes to Kaveri. After agreeing to Lord Shiva's request, Agastya asked Shiva to provide him with a water source in the south. Shiva assured him that his requirement would be fulfilled. Agastya started his journey. Soon, he reached the mountain range of Sahaya. The moment Agastya reached the Sahaya mountains in the south, the balance of the earth was restored. Amidst that mountain range, Agastya was surprised to see a beautiful woman, lost in deep meditation. He wanted to know the reason for her meditation, and that too in the middle of a huge mountain range. On being asked, the woman said, "O sage, my name is Kaveri and I am worshipping Lord Brahma to find a suitable partner for myself." Agastya could not hold back his laughter and started laughing at Kaveri. But Kaveri did not give up and resumed her worship. Agastya was impressed by Kaveri's determination and asked her to marry him. Kaveri's river form. Agastya's marriage proposal surprised Kaveri. She thought for a while and then agreed. She knew that Agastya was a wise and virtuous person. She said, "O sage, I have a request to make. I would like to help mankind in some way. As you know, this region is facing scarcity of water. I want you to transform a part of me into a river so that the dry land of south may get fertile again." The sage was impressed by the noble thoughts of Kaveri and transformed a part of her into a river. The river was named after her. Agastya did not let Kaveri flow there at the Sahaya mountains. Instead, he carried her river form in his kamandalu. Agastya and Kaveri got married and selected a beautiful mountaintop on Sahaya mountains as their abode. Unfortunately, Agastya forgot to release the water form of Kaveri in the southern part, and the part remained dry. There was drought all over. The gods in heaven were worried about the drought. Ganesha and River Kaveri. The gods decided to speak about the drought in South India to Ganesha, their savior. They knew Ganesha would definitely devise some plan to deal with the situation. They told Ganesha about the drought and how River Kaveri was kept in Agastya's kamandalu. Ganesha immediately left for Sahaya mountains, where Agastya and Kaveri resided. Agastya was meditating when Ganesha reached his hermitage. An idea struck Ganesha. He assumed the form of a crow and dived over Agastya's kamandalu. The kamandalu started tumbling down. Immediately, Agastya raised his hand to shoo away the crow. River Kaveri took Agastya's raised hand as an indication to flow down, and it started flowing down the Sahaya mountains. And finally, the dry lands of south got drenched with water and became fertile again. This is how River Kaveri was born. River Kaveri is to date one of the largest rivers in India and is serving the entire population of the region.
Thanks for watching. Do like, share, subscribe to Sahil Bookhouse.